with the name of Allah Almighty, the most gracious, the most merciful. Dear student, friend, follower, today you will people learn about major figures of speech. Then you learn what is imagery and symbolism. I will teach you all about figure of speech, imagery, conceit, hyperbole, and the rest of the devices, especially poetic devices. You know, these devices are very useful whether you are going to have literary analysis of poem or you are going to stylistically analyze poem. So these are very useful whether you are going to discuss poem with level of analysis or literary analysis of any kind of poetry. So my today's video will be for MPhil linguistic, MPhil literature, MA English, BS English, PPSC English, and the student, they have adopted English literature in their CSS exam. So let's talk about today's video. So today we'll learn what is apostrophe. You know, what is apostrophe? A direct address to an absent or the dead person's or object, quality, and idea. It's a special form of personification. So we use personification. You mean to say that personification, you mean in when to use a human characteristic or attributes to describe animals, things, idea. जब कभी हम यानी ह्यूमन कैरेक्टरिस्टिक एट्रीब्यूट्स किसी एनिमल, किसी आइडिया, किसी थिंग, किसी चीज़ को देने की कोशिश करते हैं, उसको पर्सोनिफिकेशन कहते हैं. लेकिन अपोस्ट्रॉफी जो है वो एक, आप यूँ कह लें कि ये एक डिफरेंट काइंड ऑफ, स्पेशल काइंड ऑफ ये पर्सोनिफिकेशन है. अ डायरेक्ट एड्रेस टू एन एब्सेंट और द डेड पर्सन्स और ऑब्जेक्ट, क्वालिटी और आइडिया. ऐसी चीज़ को आप मेंशन कर रहे हैं जो प्रेजेंट नहीं है, एब्सेंट है. तो ऐसी चीज़ को मेंशन करने के लिए हम बाज़ औक़ात पर्सोनिफिकेशन यूज़ करते हैं. इट इज़ स्पेशल फॉर्म ऑफ पर्सोनिफिकेशन. ये ख़ास किस्म की एक पर्सोनिफिकेशन. प्रेजेंट एंड अलाइव्स एंड कुड रिप्लाई टू व्हाट इज बीइंग सेड. ऑफन इट हैज़ अ साइन ऑफ एक्सक्लेमेशन. सो इसके साथ एक एक्सक्लेमेटरी साइन जो है वो आता है, जैसे वॉल्ट विटमैन, ओ कैप्टन he talks about Abraham Lincoln, written about the death of Abraham Lincoln. Is an example of apostrophe. Example or death, where is sitting, or give, where is the victory? Life I know not, but thou art, but know that thou and I must part. Milton, thou shouldst be living at this hour. So the thing which are absent or which is not present, you usually use this apostrophe. Then there is another personification, you know very well. Personification is a use of human characteristic or attribute to describe animals, things, ideas. Jab aap is tarah ki kisi animals ya kisi object ko, kisi cheez ko human attributes or characteristic dete hain, it is known as personifications. जैसे स्टॉमी, बस्की, ब्रॉलिंग्स, सिटी ऑफ द बिग शोल्डर्स, की डिस्क्राइब आटम एज अ हार्वेस्टर. फॉर हिम आटम इज हार्वेस्टिंग समथिंग. सिटिंग केयरलेस इन ग्रैंडरी फ्लोर्स, एग्जाम्पल डेथ लेज हिज आईसी हैंड्स ऑन द किंग. डेथ इज गिवन ह्यूमन एट्रीब्यूट्स. लेट नॉट एम्बिशन मॉक देयर यूजफुल टॉयल्स. पीस हैथ हर विक्ट्रीज नो लेस रिनोन्ड देन वॉर. सो दीज थिंग्स we use usually in you can say. So we have discussed this one. So death is kinda you can say personification over here. Ambition is a personification over here. Peace is a personification. So these things are given human value over here. Then there is a word colloquialisms, colloquial language, like that the language that is usually used. आम फहम लैंग्वेज को कहते हैं वर्ड्स जो हम यूज़. एंड इनफॉर्मल एक्सप्रेशन, नॉट फॉर्मल. फॉर्मल एक्सप्रेशन expressions mean that you use in a formal situation. So sometimes we have to be very informal with friends, with outside the office. In situations like, we have to be very informal, so we use colloquialisms. So here, if you see, over here, so this colloquialisms and informal expressions are the day-to-day language slang, especially in the context of the formal writing. So send no money, all the other lads there. So these are the you can say, these are send no money, these are the colloquialisms, so related to informal language. So let's see further. What is conceit now? Let's see what is conceit. So this word over here, conceit. Conceit, you know, this is what we are going to use. Conceit is basically far-fetched imagery. Mostly witty person they use, and as John Dryden, Samuel Johnson, he has written in his book, The Life of Abraham Kuyper. He has written that metaphysical poets are going to unite most heterogeneous idea by violence together. So he called them metaphysical poets. Now we are going to see what is imagery. So imagery, conceit, and imagery. Conceit is a kind of imagery, but it is far-fetched imagery. So going to bring idea from far-fetched places. The conceit or far-fetched imagery, it is an intellectual reference and requires intelligence to understand it. It's a display of wit and learning. It's an elaborate parallel between the two seemingly dissimilar objects. As you know, you can see over here, so the metaphysical poets, especially known for this conceit, and John Donne, so he's very prominent. So what they call far-fetched imagery, which is intellectual one, on you need wit, intellect to understand it. And as Johnson, he has called the metaphysical poets who are bringing far-fetched imagery in a way to compare things. So now there is epithet. So what is epithet? An adjectives or phrase that describe a prominent features or personal things. Richard the Lionheart, so it is, you can say, prominent kind of an adjective or phrase. And the shoeless Joe Jacksons are the example of epithet. So it's a kind of adjective or the phrase you use for the specific prominent feature of a persons or things. So here's the Richard the Lionheart, the shoeless Joe Jackson. So these are the example of epithet. Then hyperbole or overstatement. I've already explained, and in hyperbole, poet is going to exaggerate idea. Milton used it, Keats used it, Wordsworth used it. Even we find in the language of Shakespeare, he has used. So let's see, is a overstatement. So it means a kind of exaggerations. An excessive overstatement or conscious exaggeration or fact. I've told you about the million times. So million times, nobody can million times, but over here, million times. ये जो मिलियन टाइम यूज़ हुआ है, ये क्या हाइपरबली है. बहुत सारे लोग इसकी प्रोनंसिएशन जो है वो रॉन्ग प्रोनाउंस करते हैं, हाइपरबोल कहते हैं. द एग्जैक्ट प्रोनंसिएशन इज हाइपरबली. आई हैव चेक्ड इट, यू कैन चेक फ्रॉम डिक्शनरी. द एग्जैक्ट प्रोनंसिएशन इज हाइपरबली. सो हाइपरबली मीन एग्जैजरेशन, ओवर स्टेटमेंट. व्हेन राइटर इज गोना ओवरस्टेट हिज वर्ड, ही इज गोइंग टू एग्जैजरेट हिज वर्ड. अ थाउजेंड अपोलॉजी for coming late, thousand apology for coming late, thousand apology for coming test, thousand apology for late coming. So there's a Belinda smiled on the world is gay. Who said? Alexander Pope said. And then there is understatement. Otherwise, you know that that was exaggeration, but now there is a word that is understatement. So here is a form of the understatement, which is statement affirmed by negative, it's opposite. So we give meaning through opposite. So here how we are going to give meaning? So we are going to give what is affirmed. Statement is affirmed by negative, its opposite. यानी हम उस statement को affirm करेंगे लेकिन negative लिए, जैसे I'm not a little surprised. It means that I'm big surprised. He is son of no mean person. क्योंकि ये आम बंदे का बेटा नहीं है. He is dullard, very clever. So he is no dullard. यानी वो कोई dull नहीं है. So here we are going to explain an idea like that. So here is an idiom. Idiom is a common expression that is acquired meaning that different from its literal meaning. So idioms and the literal, what is dictionary meaning and what is the meaning of idiom, that can be totally different. So you have to go from, you have to get from the context. So it is not literal meaning you get. Such it is a raising cats and dogs. So cats and dogs, you will totally surprise what is the meaning of cats and dogs. It's raining cat and dog. That means to say raining is going on. You say that it's like cat and dog. So cat and dog is you have to judge it through context. Bird from the blue. So here again you have to judge from the context, not from the wordings. So let's see further. Simile. Simile is a